Hi guys, it's Alex Campbell here. I'm a 19-year-old student from Colchester in Essex. Now, some of you may have heard of Essex because of the woefully bad TV show, The Only Way is Essex, and for that I can only apologise and accept no responsibility in the making of the show. Currently though, I'm a student at the University of Durham, which is in the northeast of the UK. I'm currently studying international relations, which is essentially a more global and international version of politics. When I leave university, I want to go straight into full-time employment, either as a teacher, perhaps working for the government in civil service, or maybe looking further afield into international organisations such as Facebook or something like the UN. Now, why I want to do Camp America? Camp America combines three things that I think are really important in my life. The first is travelling, the second is being able to work and engage with children, and the third is my love for sport, mainly tennis. My love for travelling began about a year ago when I was able to take a year out between school and university, and during this year out I was fortunate enough to visit a huge range of beautiful countries, which provided me a really wide opportunities of incredible experiences, from getting my advanced open water diving certificate in Madagascar, where I did a couple of wreck dives, two night dives, and diving every day for a month, conducting reef surveys on this beautiful pristine coral reef with clear blue crystal waters, to then something like trekking in the Himalayas in the Annapurna mountain range, getting up to 3,200 meters with these spectacular views, and then something completely different to working 5 days a week in a local primary school in Pokhara, Nepal, which is the second largest city in Nepal, which though at times was challenging, where you've got to try and adapt to different children's learning styles, was ultimately a really rewarding process, and I hope something that stays with me for the rest of my life. My love for sport grew from a young age, where I've got early memories of playing rugbys 4 to 3 times a week, either at school or for my local club, to being involved with the local Saturday football session, to mainly playing tennis though, which where my earliest memories start when the whole family on my mum's side would go out to Portugal, and we'd all be thrown in, all 9 of the cousins, into the weekly 9 till 11 tennis slot, which really developed my love for the game. And since then, since those early memories, I've been playing competitively, either for my local club or at school, to now where I've taken up more of a coaching role. I think it was last February when I got my first coaching qualification, my LTA level 1. And this January, when I got my LTA level 2, and coaching has opened up a whole new realm of tennis to me, where you can pass, where I can pass my love of the game onto the next generation, where I can see that competitive edge, and or where I can see children pick up a racket for the first time and see the joy on their faces of being able to hit the ball and get on court and getting involved in the game that I love. On a light note, a couple of personal and fun facts about me. I was born with 34 teeth instead of 32, because I had 2 clone teeth from birth, which apparently is pretty rare. For me, that's my fun fact. We have to do a lot of icebreakers at university, and that would always be the one that I would trot out. Also, I'm currently training for the London Marathon in April, so touch wood, that all goes to plan. Training at the moment, and it can be pretty cold, pretty tiring, but quite time consuming, but I know it's going to be really worth it when I cross the finish line in April to finally my perfect dinner party, and my favourite dinner party guests. I think the first would have to be Billie Jean King. I think her impact on tennis, and especially women's tennis, with the demand for equal pay, to the establishment of the WTO, which still exists today, which is a real credit to her and her mindset and drive and determination in the game. Secondly, as a history lover, I think it would have to be Winston Churchill. I think the impact that he's had on UK society and Europe, European society, cannot be understated. And I think he'll go down as one of the most influential people, not just within the 20th century, but I think globally for centuries to come. And then finally, I think I'd have to lighten the mood potentially with a comedian. So I think I would throw in Jack Whitehall, who's a UK comedian, who I really like his work. I don't know, he's done a little bit in America, but he's pretty prominent in the UK. And I think he would add another dynamic to the group. So that's me. Thanks very much for listening, guys. Looking forward to hearing from you. Goodbye.